Once you've downloaded and installed your W-2 1099 software, you're ready to activate it and begin using it. To activate it, you'll need a password, which will appear on the left-hand side on your Procare News tab about one business day after your order is received. Another way to get your activation code is to go to the Help menu in the upper right and choose Procare Store website. There, you'll click on your Order History tab, and it will also display your activation code there. To get started, we'll go to the Utilities menu, choose Procare Extras, and this is where you'll find the W-2 and 1099 software. At this point, I'd be asked for my activation password if this was the first time I was using the software on this computer. I've been in here before, so it takes me right in. You'll start out by selecting a data source. If you've been previously working and saved your data, you can get back to the point at which you left off by clicking Load Previously Saved Data. I'm going to start out from scratch by selecting a region. If you have more than one region, you would do W-2s for each region one at a time, come back to the screen, select the next region, and continue. I happen to have just one region here called Southern Oregon, which is already selected. We'll go ahead and exit. Because I was working in here before, it asked me if I want to start over. Am I done with my currently saved data? And I am. I want to start from scratch, so I'll say yes. Next step is to go to Company Info. This is where you fill out the basic contact information for your center. Be sure to input your employer identification number, also known as your tax ID number. And if you're going to be e-filing your federal W-2s, in the upper right is a place to put in your business services online user ID that you obtained from the Social Security Administration. Then we'll go ahead and exit. And next we go on to step three, which is the state ID numbers. Any states for which you've had withholdings will automatically be listed here, and you'll simply type in your state tax ID number. If there were other states for some reason that you needed to report withholdings or wages for, or something for a vendor for a 1099 that was for some reason not listed here, you can click Add State and manually put in additional states. Next up, on the W-2 side, we'll continue with Map General Withholdings. Mapping simply means to assign a withholding in Procare to a particular box on the W-2. You get a list of all the general withholdings that you have used during the year for things like employee child care, maybe a local city tax, health insurance, retirement plan, that sort of thing. If you have a withholding that does not belong on the W-2 at all, you would leave it blank. You wouldn't fill in any of these boxes. If the withholding is supposed to be reported in one of the boxes listed, you'll indicate so here. And you'll want to confer with your tax advisor and or the instructions from the IRS. Let's just say, for example, this first one did not need to be reported. I'll leave that one blank. If the second one belongs in box 10, I'll place a check mark on that box. The next one perhaps is a local tax, and I might put in the name of my city. Then I have a health plan. Perhaps that one I'm advised to report in box 14. Again, these are just examples. And then we'll look down the list and see if there are any others. And maybe this one should be reported in box 12. Again, I've confirmed with my tax advisor and or the IRS as to the appropriate boxes. Toward the bottom, you'll see the option to automatically correct Social Security and Medicare withholdings. You are encouraged to use this setting to ensure the proper amounts are reported. For details, search ProcareSupport.com for the phrase automatically corrected. When we click exit, all the withholdings will be imported from the individual employee paychecks to the W-2 screen. In this case, it's reminding me that I have not mapped all of the withholdings. I've chosen purposely that some of these will not be included on the W-2, so I'll say yes, I want to continue anyway. The next thing to do is to review and edit the W-2s, and this will be a place where you can include things in other boxes or make corrections and so forth. In the upper left, you'll have a list of your schools, if you have more than one, that all the schools that fall within this particular region, and you can expand or contract those by clicking the little plus and minus signs here. You'll want to look at each employee's information and review it to make sure that it makes sense before you continue. From this screen, if you needed to, you could make a manual correction or add something else. You could type in the box like other to manually add something if you needed to. You can also change an item. If you're going to make a change, click in the box and backspace out the item and then enter the change. And then you'd go through each of the employees and just quickly review to make sure that things are appropriate. When you're done with that, you'd simply exit. And now you're ready to move on and print and or e-file the W-2s. We'll click on Print W-2s and W-3. And I get a warning at the top. This is reminding me that there were some general withholdings I chose not to import to the W-2. And in the lower right, then I will confirm that I'm ready to continue or that I need to go back and make some more changes. I'm saying that I'm ready to print. It'll let me exit this screen. And now I'll select my printer from the drop-down list. I'll choose a font. The IRS recommends Courier 12. We'll say OK. And then we can move on and print a test page. Typically, you'll print this out on plain white paper and then hold it up to the light against a regular W-2 to make sure that things align OK. If you need to move things up or down or left or right, you can use the Adjust Printer setting here. Using little arrows, we'll move the print space up or down and to the left or to the right for slight adjustments. Then you would exit here and print an additional test page until you get things lined up appropriately. When you're ready to print them, you'll actually put the forms into your printer. You'd want to put one copy at a time. So for example, copy A of the W-2s, and then you would click Print W-2s, and it's going to immediately send that to the printer. Then you'd put in copy B, print those, copy C, print those, and so forth. When you've printed all the W-2s, you're ready to go on and print the W-3s. This is also the screen to go to for e-filing. So we'll go to Print the W-3s. This is a screen where you can review any information that is on the W-3. You can't make any changes to these boxes, but you can review the information here. Okay, you can manually enter information in box 14 if you need to. And then from here, you'd put your W-3 form into the printer and simply click the print button. If you're going to be e-filing, in the top right you'll find that there's a button here for EFW2 export. This will allow you to create an export file that you can then import to the SSA website. So to do that, you'll click on the EFW2 export button and choose a location you want to export the file to. I'm going to choose my desktop, say OK. And the EF2 file for this region exists already. That's because I've done this as a practice earlier on. So I'm saying yes, I want to create a new one. And the name of the file is EFW2 underscore whatever the name of my region is, .txt. And I have a choice to open the folder that it's in. I'm going to say no for that for right now. So now I have a text file on my desktop that I can then import to the Social Security website. You're going to want to make sure that you safeguard that text file, since it includes sensitive information. To complete your e-filing, you'll go to the Social Security Administration website. You can manually go there or click the link using the Social Security Administration icon in the upper right that will take you to the website. There you'll log in with your username and password for that site and follow their instructions for how to upload and import and complete your e-filing. And that's really all there is to using the W-2 program to print or e-file your federal W-2s. For state W-2s, there is no automatic e-filing. You could use the information on screen here to help you fill in information on your state's W-2 website, or perhaps copy and paste information from one screen to the next. And that's all there is to printing and e-filing your W-2s with Procare.